Hello, my name is James Hedge. I'm the director and one of the drum teachers at MusicStation. We've been open since 2013, and in that time we've taught over 100,000 lessons in drums, guitar, bass, keyboards and vocals. I'm a very experienced, qualified teacher. I've been teaching over 30 years in London and the South East. I've taught in schools, colleges, universities and private music schools, and now my own music school, MusicStation. Since starting MusicStation, I've also worked as the lead consultant for the new Trinity Rock and Pop drum syllabus. I'm very proud to say it's an enormous success and has now been taught all over the world. I'm currently developing a brand new beginner drum syllabus that you can try if you sign up for lessons here at MusicStation. After years of teaching and constant research, I was dissatisfied with what was available out there for beginner drummers, so I decided to work on my own. This new approach has a lot of play-along videos and audio, lots of explanation, and with it you'll learn very fast and learn the correct way to play as well. Alongside my teaching, I've also had a career as a professional musician. I've recorded albums and toured with many artists, and I'll be very happy to share all of that experience with you if you sign up for lessons at MusicStation. We have some of the top teachers and players in the country ready to start teaching you now on all instruments. Why not start a new instrument in 2021? It's so much fun to learn how to play, and you'll get a much deeper understanding of music. If you're already playing, we can help you develop your skills and technique to become a professional drummer or just a hobbyist that has fun. This video contains some edited highlights of a lesson with Thomas, who's just finishing his Trinity Rock and Pop Grade 4. We start by warming up with a fulcrum finger exercise. This will help you to develop much more strength in your hands. Once you get control of the fingers, you start to feel the bounce coming back into your hand, don't you? Mm. Once you can feel it, it's like you're waking your hand up now. And once you can feel it, it's great. It's like the stabilizers are off. And you can always feel the amount of bounce coming back off the snare. That means there's a whole new world of very interesting beats that you're going to be able to play. So yeah, we'll also have a quick warm up with that in a minute actually. I'll see how you're doing. Well done. Well done indeed. That is so challenging to get all the subdivisions like that as well. So in time, the fingers will get stronger and stronger. So, oh yeah, finally on that sheet actually of the fulcrum exercise, don't forget to bring all the fingers back. Because when you go back to using all the fingers, say we're just doing groups of four, you can feel the bounce so much more after running through each finger. And remember, we're only using fingers, maybe a tiny bit of wrist, but imagine your arm is in a plaster cast. You can't move it and you still have to play. Good.
We then go on to study some drags and how to incorporate them into grooves. We then move into some buzzes with one hand and to play grooves similar to what Prince played on Musicology. This is a song in the Trinity Grade 5 drum syllabus.
First up, notice in the middle of this first bar we have these two 32nd note left hands. Now that's a lot of ink
to be using every time you want to write a drag or a double. So if you look to the end of the bar, you see the abbreviated version. So you just put a slash through the note, and that just tells you that that is going to be doubled. And notice it's got a small bracket around it, which means in this case we're going to ghost the note. I'm trying to get a really controlled double. Now, I can see you working it out. Well done. Now, what the challenge here is, let me just switch my camera angle for a sec so you can see my hands a little bit clearer. When you play this controlled double, what you're doing at the moment is you're bringing the stick up as though you're about to play an accented or a loud note. But they're ghosted. So if you can... you can get that small bounce. So when you play your accented two, hold the stick down, downstroke, and then you do your two taps, and then you get ready for beat four. Good. That's getting better every single time you do it. So that's quite a common funk beat with the two ghost notes in the middle. And I'm going to put the drag on the end. What you can also do with your drags is you can play, use them going, it just makes everything sound a little bit more exciting leading into a fill. So without the drag, yes, I sometimes would use them on the hi-hat as well. So the buzz, the shorthand notation here, is just this little Z that goes through the note, and that will just tell you to buzz that note. So what we do, we go one and two. So I'm actually pushing down, and you can control the amount of bounce. Yeah, you got it. So the challenge is this hand is going to be playing straight eighths, and then this hand is going to be pushing down. So it's two very different movements. So it's going to be this. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Give it a try. But we mentioned Musicology by Prince. And what he's done has moved the backbeat from beat four, a 16th later. So it's on the E of four. So this takes a little bit of getting used to. So you go.
We finish with a run through of Can't Get Enough by Bad Company. The
This is one of Thomas's grade 4 pieces. I think he's doing really well with it. To see some of you online very soon. Please go to musicstation.pro for more information about our lessons. Keep practicing.
musicstation.pro